Ladies and gentlemen, the American drama group Europe proudly presents for your entertainment, just behind this curtain, direct from the land of the mighty Mississippi River and the home of Elvis. The one, the only hoodoo portable players and big dog traveling minstrel show. Mukti for Hong off, boys. Ha! 1, 2, 3, 4. Everything we need, a platform and a passion.
We bring our show to town and leave them laughing and crying. We ain't got time to stick around, but we're available for lunch if you're buying.
We'll present exotic wonders to astound you. And any kind of rhythm to get down to. We can even do impressions of the king. Oh, baby.
Won't you buy a program?
It only costs 3 marks.
Settle back and watch us now and let your troubles go.
We're the Hoodoo Portable Players and Big Dog Traveling Minstrel Show.
Of Huckleberry Finn. Now, this was written in the 1800s by Mr. Samuel Langhorne Clemens, better known as Mark Twain. It is set on the banks of the mighty Mississippi River in the period before the American Civil War, and life was different then.
Life was very different then.
Supposed to be working somewhere.
Well, sir, you know me. I'm Jim. I belong to Miss Watson.
Well, I don't see you working, Jim. Folks, I believe we have a slave here that hasn't got anything better to do but tap his feet and listen to music. Hey, you like our music, Jim?
Yes, sir. It's mighty fine.
Kind of makes you tap your foot, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
Makes you want to sing, doesn't it?
Yes, sir. If I could, I surely would, and that's the truth.
Oh, don't tell me you can't sing. I never seen a nigger couldn't sing.
Well, sir, I'm the first. I couldn't sing a song if my life depended on it.
Well, you can dance, can't you? Tell me you can dance, at least.
No, sir, I regret it, but my feet get all tangled up every time. No, I'll just sit here and get me an earful of music.
Well, all right, then stand up.
Excuse me, sir.
I said stand up! And when a man tells you to stand up, you better do it. Now stand up!
Sir, I told you, I don't want no trouble.
You can't sing or dance, you say.
No, sir, I told you, I can't.
Well, I expect if I start firing this gun at your feet, then you'd sing, wouldn't you?
Now, sir, ain't no need of pointing no gun at me. I told you, I don't want no trouble. Just let me get on back to Miss Watson.
No! I want you to sing, Jim.
Sir, I told you I could
sing! We all want you to sing, don't we, huh? Don't we? Huh? Well, play something. You don't want to play. Well, I can do without all of you. Now you sing for me.
When my life is o'er, I'll fly away to my home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away.
I'll go on home. That Jim, he's something, isn't he?
He is that.
Well, hey, Picker, play another song. I'm not through dancing.
No.
What do you mean, no?
Just what I said, no.
Well, hey!
No more music today.
Well, if you're not an unfriendly person, that makes two times now I ask you to play a song and you refuse.
That's my decision to make, isn't it?
Are you crossing me?
Not necessarily, but you hear me. I'm not like poor Jim here. I've not been taught to run from a man. You had no reason to shame him, Pap. You had no reason at all.
I'll do what I want to do.
I don't think you will. Pap, you get that hand up here where I can see it.
Oh, come on now. What's the matter with you? Are you some kind of nigger lover? Are you some kind of abolitionist or something?
No, I'm not. And you ain't much of a man. Now get the hell out of my sight. Come on home. Ain't that what you told Jim? Well, come on home.
Abolitionist, Picker.
Well, Huck, that's a man that thinks one man should not be able to own another one. Wants to see slavery abolished. He'd like to see the slaves set free.
You think we'd be right to free the slaves?
I don't know, Huck. Every man's got to make up his own mind on that. Now, what do you think?
My pap says a slave's nothing but a piece of property.
Yeah? What do you think? You believe him? You think he's right?
I don't know.
Well, here's your chance to ask him. He's coming back this way.
Oh, Lord. Don't you tell him you see me. You promise.
Promise.
You promise.
I promise. Go on.
Picker, have you seen that no good boy of mine?
No.
Don't you lie to me. Well, somebody said they saw him coming this way 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, I haven't seen him.
Well, he better hope I don't find him, because I'm going to beat him with a bullwhip when I do. You watch me, see if I don't. Say, have you got a nickel?
Stone broke, Pap.
Well, that figures. You music boys don't ever have any money to your name. You're all sorry as hell, every damn one of you.
That's not much of a father, is it? Now that to me was Huck's main problem. You know who Huck is, don't you? That young fellow that just ran off over there. That's the one and only Huckleberry Finn. The one and only. Now back in the 1870s, Mark Twain made Huck and his friend Tom Sawyer about as famous as any two boys could be.
And I didn't want no part of that, Picker.
That's true, he didn't. All Huck wanted to do was have a little fun, not hurt anybody doing it. But no matter how hard he tried, he kept getting into one fix after another. And this bothered Huck, because he didn't have anybody to talk to. He was all alone. This gets me back to what I thought was Huck's main problem. You see, Huck's mama died when he was just a baby. He couldn't
tell them I missed my mama. Don't forget that now.
Excuse me, just a minute, will you? Huck, come on down here. Now, come on. Are you going to keep interrupting me as I endeavor to tell these good people your story? Is that going to be happening all day?
I just want you to get my story right.
Well, I can understand that.
I missed my mother.
Got it.
But not my pap.
But not your pap.
I wanted to miss him, but I couldn't. He wouldn't leave.
Well, it makes sense.
Well, get on with it then. What's holding you back?
He's a good boy, generally. He just gets excited. Now, Huck had nobody to tell him what to do and what not to do. So naturally, he just took to the woods. For weeks on end, he would run wild. It's like a creature in the woods. But you know something? There were a lot of people that saw the makings of some good in Huck. A lot of people. Take, for example, these two fine ladies here. This is the Widow Douglas.
My husband is dead. Pleased to meet you.
And this beauty here is her sister, Miss Watson.
My husband is not dead.
But sister, you do not have a husband.
A pleasure to meet you.
Well, anyway, Widow Douglas and Miss Watson, they were both good Christian women.
Praise the Lord.
And they were determined to save Huck from eternal damnation.
Fire and brimstone.
And they wanted to get him a little education while they were saving his soul. So what they did was they relocated him from the woods. Now, strictly between you and me, they dragged him out of the woods. They took him to the widow's house. They cleaned him up. They put a book in his hand instead of a fishing rod. And that is where the fun starts.
All right, Huckleberry, let's proceed.
A, B, C, D, E, L, G, 6, 7, R, G.
Ow! Damn! Ow!
Don't curse.
I wasn't.
God almighty, why are you...
Ow!
Don't curse.
Proceed.
A, B, C, D, E, L, G, 6, 7, R, G, Y.
I wish I was back in the woods. God knows I do. Ow! Don't take the Lord's name in vain.
I wasn't.
Oh, my little lost lamb. You will never have to sleep in the woods again. Your home is here now. And you'll go to school every day.
And church every Sunday.
And before long, you will be civilized in every way. Oh, isn't it wonderful?
I wish I was back in the woods.
Time for Bible study.
Oh, my God.
What? Praise God. Now, this is the story of the little baby Moses hidden among the bulrushes.
Are these folks in heaven?
Who, child?
Moses and them bulrushing fellers. Are they in heaven?
Most certainly Moses is, dear. Don't smoke that pipe, child. It's a bad habit. Try not to continue with it.
But Widow Douglas smoked cigars.
Oh, Huckleberry, don't you want to be good? Don't you want to go to the good place and not the bad place?
Well, that depends. What's the bad place like?
It's all fire and brimstone and gnashing of teeth. Terrible gnashing of teeth.
Well, what's there to do in heaven?
Well, you just go around all day with a harp and sing forever and ever.
That's it?
Oh, child, isn't that enough?
Well, are you two going to be in the good place?
Oh, yes!
Well, then I expect I'll take my chances in the bad place.
Wait a minute. Huckleberry, you go to your room and pray. The Lord will guide you.
God, God,
she,
if you,
well, oh, look at you, aren't you pretty, all starched up and clean?
Maybe I am, maybe I ain't.
Don't you talk to me that way, boy. I'll slap you down as soon as look at you. Where have you been hiding from me?
I ain't been hiding.
You've been hiding from me. Say, I hear you got educated while I was gone. I guess that puts you above your old pappy now, don't it? Who told you to mess with such foolishness? Who told you you could?
The widow. She told me I could.
The widow? Well, who told her she could? Did the widow bring you into this world? Did she? I don't think she did. I think I did that. But let's prove it. Come on. Say some education for me. By God, I'd like to hear some.
A, B, C, D, E, L, G, 6, 7, R, G, Y.
That doesn't prove anything. Pick up that Bible and read from it. Pick it up, I say!
And Moses went up and met with them bulrusher fellers. And they went and they got a hold of some good-sized wings and flapped over the mountain and into heaven, where there wasn't no teeth gnashing to speak of, and plenty of harps for everybody.
So it's true. You can read. Put that foolishness out of your mind, dandy boy. I won't have it! Reading and writing. I can't read, and your mama couldn't read either. So you put it out of your mind. No! You put your stuff together. You're coming with me.
I want to stay here.
You get your poke together and come on. Where did you learn to talk to your daddy that way? I'll teach you another way soon enough. Now you come on.
Yes? Come and sit. Sister, you must help me. Tell me what to do about Jim.
Yes, Jim belongs to you. What you do with him is your decision, not mine. Well, what did the trader say?
$800. That's what he said.
$800? So that's what Jim is worth.
Indeed. What am I to do? I am not rich, and that boy needs food, clothes, and education. I see no other choice but to sell Jim.
Well, did the trader say that he would take Jim's family in the bargain?
No. And that one thing lays heaviest on my heart.
Oh, my dear. Why don't you let it rest for tonight? We'll decide tomorrow. Come.
They're gonna sell me. They're gonna sell me. What am I gonna do?
Well, Jim was in a fix, and so was Huck. Jim was gonna be sold, and Huck was Pap's prisoner. Might as well say they were both slaves.
Come on, boy. Come on.
No.
Here we are.
Get in there. Hey, dandy boy. Hey, pretty boy.
Damn it. Who took my liquor? Hey, pretty boy. Say some more education for me. Education is a good thing to have out here in the middle of the woods, isn't it? Isn't it?
I reckon so.
Damn it. I don't know education. I don't know none. I don't know how I got along without education all these years. Education. A, B. How does it go?
A, B, C, D, E, L, G, 6, 7, 1.
That's good, boy. That's real good. Now you listen to me. Hey, where's the Widow Douglas, dandy boy? Where is she? Is she gonna come here and save you?
I don't reckon she will.
Well, she better stay away. Stay where she's at. Come in. Anybody tries to come here, I'll kill them. Stay away from me, everybody. Stay away. I need something to drink. Stay away. There's a snake on me. Get the snake off.
There ain't no snakes on you, Pat.
He's biting me on the neck. Get him off. Get him off. There's dead people in here. There's dead people. Angel of death.
It's me, Pat.
Are you coming for me? Are you coming for me?
It's your son. It's Huck.
Stay away from me. I'll stick you with a knife. I'll make you die.
Put that thing down, Pap. I'm begging you. Huck is begging you.
I'll stick you. I'll kill you, angel of death. I'll stick you like a pig. I'll stick you. I'll kill you. I kill you.
Wake up. Hey! What are you doing with my gun?
Somebody was trying to get in. I was laying up for him.
Why didn't you wake me up?
I tried to, but you was fast asleep. You wouldn't move.
All right. Well, don't stand there looking at me.
I need some more liquor. I'm going into town. Hey, come here. Come here. Come here! Now you listen. If you try to run away, I will find you no matter where you go. So you be here when I come back.
Huck had enough. Now he knew that if Pap came back full of liquor one more time, somebody was going to end up dead. So he knew he had to escape. He sat, thought for a while, came up with a plan. Now he knew that the only way Widow Douglas and Pap were going to leave him alone is if they thought he was dead.
So I'll just make everybody think I'm dead.
Went outside. He took a look around. And in just a few minutes, the answer to Huck's problem came trotting by in the form of a wild pig. Huck cut that pig's throat and carried him back into the cabin. Took him inside. Physically. He got a hold of some of that pig's blood and he smeared it all over that vest. Pulled a few hairs out of his head and laid them along the blade of the knife. And then he took that pig and he dragged him all over the floor of the cabin so that anybody coming in would naturally think someone had come along and murdered Huck, which is just what Huck wanted him to think. Now, he didn't know where to go, so he headed down to the river. He sat there by that riverbank, and he contemplated his next move. Inside of 10 minutes, a fine big raft came floating down the river. Huck jumped on that raft. And down the river he went. He was floating, ladies and gentlemen, down the finest river God ever gave a man. Ladies and gentlemen, the mighty Mississippi River. Now, he hadn't been there very long before Jackson Island come into sight. Now, Huck thought he'd put ashore, you see, because he'd known Jackson Island all his life, and he knew there wasn't anybody living there. So, whatever his next move was going to be, he had plenty of time to figure it out.
Lord. Jim! It's Jim!
Don't harm me, don't! I have never done harm to a ghost. I always liked ghosts. Done all I could for them. So just get on back in the river where you belong and don't harm Jim.
No! Jim, I ain't no ghost.
You are!
Hey, Jim. I'm Huckleberry Finn.
Well, you are a ghost, I reckon. Huck. All the folks in town are saying you was killed in that cabin you had with your pal.
No, I just made it look that way so I could get me some breathing room. I thought my pap was gonna kill me.
Well, who was it got killed in the cabin?
A pig.
A pig?
I killed me a wild pig, Jim. Smeared his blood all over the cabin. Made as nice a murder scene as anybody would want. And me, I'm three on the Mississippi.
Oh, you know what that was, Huck? That was brains working. Tom Sawyer couldn't come up with a better plan than that.
It wasn't that special.
Oh, it was, too.
Well, say now, Jim, how did you get here on this island?
Maybe I better not tell you.
Why not?
There are reasons. But if I tell you, you promise to keep it a secret, not tell anybody.
I'll keep it a secret. Promise I will.
I believe you, Huck. I ran away.
Jim.
Now, mind you said you wouldn't tell.
Well, I said I wouldn't, and I'll stick to it. So let's hear all about it.
Well, it was this way. Old Miss Watson, she always said she'd never sell me. Well, the other night, I creeps in the door real quiet-like, and I hear Miss Watson and the old widow talking, saying they was thinking to sell me for $800.
$800?
Yeah, and she said she needs the money to educate you. So I ran out real quick. They weren't gonna let me stay with my family, Huck. I knew I couldn't stand that.
But then how'd you hear I was dead?
I hid in a barn for 7 hours. Two men come in looking for a bridle and a harness, saying they was going out in the morning to look for Huck Finn's body. Oh, I was powerful sorry you were dead, Huck. But I ain't sorry no more, because here you are.
I'll be darned, Jim. It's good.
Get down. I heard something.
Oh, Jim, that ain't nothing but the wind.
I'll be if I don't get scared every time I hear a leaf fall. I think people coming to get me every time I turn around, Huck.
Well, Jim, I tell you what. I'll be a lookout of sorts. Help you keep on top of things. How would that be?
That'd be good, Huck.
You want to smoke? Settle back.
No. I'm not just worried about getting caught. I'm worried about my family. I get the feeling I'm not going to see my wife and children no more. Poor little Elizabeth. Poor little Johnny. I've never been away from home before, Huck. It's hard.
I don't know if this would help you or not, but you can pretend like I'm your son. That'd be all right with me if you think it would help you.
It might. It just might. Well, look, you need anything? You need some cover? Let me get you some cover. Looks like a storm's coming up. I'll stand watch. You'll be all right. To another storm, you can save mine.
I'll sure do it, Jim.
Huck,
Gimme that old house over there. Let's take a look-see. Ain't no telling what we might find.
Jim, we got some nice things here. Look at this shirt.
Huck, look what I found here. We're rich.
$8. $8.
$8.
$8.
We're rich.
This plus $800. Makes $808.
$800? What $800 are you talking about?
Didn't you tell me they was gonna sell you for $800? Well, when we get you down to freedom, you're gonna own yourself. So you're gonna be worth $800.
I reckon you're right. I own myself now. Oh, Huck, we rich for sure. I don't know. There's a lot of bad luck hanging on this. That dress was stolen. And this money, it's got a bad history behind it before you and me ever touched it. No, trouble is coming.
Shoot. I'm not gonna sit here and wait for it. I'm going into town and see what people are saying about you and me.
Huck, are you gone crazy? You go into town, and everybody sees that boy, Huckleberry Finn. They're gonna know.
They won't see that boy. I'll be a girl.
Well, it just might work. Go ahead, go ahead. Wait, there, put that on. Well, put your arm in there. Okay. Oh, yeah, you're gonna look just fine. Well, wait. Try this bonnet on. Might as well go all the way. There. Oh, yeah. Won't anybody even know it's you? Oh, you're beautiful.
Oh, do you think so?
Oh, yes. You're beautiful. Oh. May I have a kiss?
Oh, none of that.
Oh, come on now.
Let me go on into town, Jim. I'm gonna see what people are saying about you and me.
All right, but be careful.
I will.
And don't talk too much. You give yourself away.
I won't.
Trouble's coming. I know the signs. It's coming.
Hello there. Hello there. Shoot, that's terrible.
You gotta be somebody, even if you don't wanna
to be. Well, come in, child. Sit.
Thank you, ma'am.
What's your name, child?
My name is Sarah Williams.
Well, Sarah Williams, you live around these parts?
No, ma'am, I live in Hookerville, about 7 miles down from here.
You want a bite to eat?
Oh, no, thank you, ma'am. I ate about 2 hours ago at Uncle Abner Moore's farm. You ever heard of him?
No, but I haven't met everybody yet. We just moved here a few weeks ago. The fact is, my husband's with the neighbors right now, getting ready to saddle up a horse.
Is your husband leaving town for a while?
No! They're heading out to try to collect that reward.
What reward would that be?
Well, where did you say you was from?
I didn't.
Yes, you did. You said you was from Huckleberry.
That's right. Huckleberry.
Well, if you was from Huckleberry, you ought to have heard the excitement by now. You heard of Huck Finn. Old man Finn's boy. Well, anyway, young Huck and his pack had an old cabin down by the river, and somebody snuck in there and murdered Huck one day a couple of weeks ago.
Well, I'll be darned. They got any idea who might have done it?
Well, everybody judged it was done by a runaway slave named Jim.
Why, he never done nothing.
What, child?
Nothing. So why they think Jim done it?
Well, the slave ran off the very night Huck Finn was murdered. Nobody's seen him since.
Well, so everybody's convinced that Jim done it?
Well, if they weren't before, they sure was when the sheriff put $300 reward on that slave's head.
$300? That's a powerful lot of money.
Well, you go get that, Jim, and you'll have it. But you better be quick about it. The men is leaving tonight.
Tonight?
What did you say your name was?
Mary. Mary Williams.
I thought you said your name was Sarah.
That's right. Sarah Mary Williams. Some people call me Sarah, and others call me Jane.
Jane?
Yes, ma'am.
Sarah Mary Jane Williams?
Yes, ma'am. I gotta go. Bye now.
Fare thee well, Sarah Mary. Jane? Jane? Jane?
Oh, whoa here, whoa.
Hurry, Jim, there's men after us.
Well, what, are they coming after me because I ran away?
They're coming after you for murder. They think you murdered me, Jim.
Murder? You? Where'd they get that from, Huck?
The woman told me you disappeared the same night I was killed. And now everybody thinks you killed me.
So they're gonna try and hang me for killing you. Well, you just go and tell them I didn't do it.
I can't, Jim. I'll get in trouble for helping a runaway slave.
All right, Huck. I won't ask for your help no more.
Who goes there?
Wait, Jim. Get under this blanket.
Well, put that stuff away.
Hello there.
Who goes there?
Jim.
Who?
Jim Miller.
Oh.
You belong on that raft, Miller?
Yes, sir, it's mine.
You got any men on it?
Just one, sir.
Well, there's a runaway slave out, and I'm out to collect him. Is your man white or black?
He's white.
I reckon I'll just come take a look for myself.
I wish you would. It's my pap that's there, and he's awful sick.
What's the matter with him?
He's got the smallpox.
Why, smallpox? God, wind probably blew it all over about now. Why didn't you say so before?
Well, I told everybody before, but they just went away and left us.
Look,
see. I expect your pap's poor and you don't have any money. I have a $20 gold piece. I'll put it on this rail and you can come and get it after I've gone.
Thank you, sir.
You helped me, Huck.
Quiet, Jim.
You helped me. You could have turned me in. All your troubles would have been over. But you said you'd help me, and you did.
Jim, now shush.
There he goes, the old true Huck. When I get my freedom, I'm going to buy my wife and children back. I'm going to tell them all about Huck Finn. You see if I don't.
I hope that day comes for you, Jim.
Oh, it's coming. I know the signs. It's coming.
Stop! Help! Help! Help me! Help! Oh! Help! Help an old man, please! Please, come a little closer! Oh, thank you, boy! Oh, come on now, come on! Hurry up, let's go! Shove off, boy!
Hold it there! Who in blazes do you think you are?
You ain't this, young fella! Shove off! We'll have a chat in a little while.
Ah, here they come!
Here they come!
There's something under the blanket, boys.
That's Jim.
How do?
Hello. Let's get away from those dogs. Hello, Jim.
You fellas just can't take my boat.
Easy. We got away. Oh. Fare thee well, idiots and fools. Now, introductions all around. Jim, you say?
That's right.
What's your name, young man?
George. George Miller.
George and Jim. Jim and George. Sir, may I present to you our rescuers?
You may.
What are you fellas running from?
A group of ungrateful people, mostly. A man tries to do right.
And what comes from it? Nothing but trouble and heartbreak. Say, this man and I, we just met on our little run down to the river. Why were they chasing you?
Well, I was selling medicine to take tartar off the teeth, and it does take it off too, but it makes your teeth fall out. Well, I'd sold 50 bottles, and I was just running away when I met you. That's the whole story. What's yours?
Well, I was having a little church meeting back there in town, a little evangelist meeting. I was preaching the evils of alcohol. But the town people caught me with my private bottle. I was having a little trouble walking and talking. I was drunk, actually. And they chased me off, and here I am.
Hard to make a dollar these days. Say, maybe you and me should team up. What do you think?
Well, I might consider it. What do you do? What's your line?
Sometimes I sell medicine. Sometimes I'm a theater actor. Tragedy, you know. I'll do most anything to make a dollar. What would yours be?
Oh, I'm a preacher, son. I'm a minister. A minister of the Word of God. I bring people back into the fold of righteousness. As long as they pay for it. Men and women cost a dollar, and children half price. But enough about me. What about you, young man? What's your story? Now tell me, why did you have your man all covered up under a blanket? He's not a runaway slave, is he?
Goodness sakes! Would a runaway run south?
No, I don't suppose he would.
Alas.
What are you lassing about?
To think I should have lived to be leading such a life and be degraded down to such company.
What's wrong with the company? We haven't done anything.
No, I know you have not. I don't blame you. I have brought myself down. It's right I should suffer. I can't go on.
Brought you down from where? Where were you brought down from?
Oh, you would not believe me. The world never believes. It doesn't matter. Let it pass. The secret of my birth.
The secret of your birth? Do you mean?
Gentlemen, by rights, I am a duke.
A duke? No, you can't mean it.
Yes, 'tis true. My great-grandfather, the Duke of Bridgewater, fled to this country about the end of the last century to breathe the pure air of freedom. He married here and died, leaving a son. I am the lineal descendant of that infant. I am the rightful Duke of Bridgewater. And here I am, forlorn, worn, torn from my high estate, and degraded to the companionship of criminals on a raft.
Well, shoot, we don't know what to say.
I do, but I'll keep from saying it.
Jim, we got us a sure enough duke on this raft.
I heard it. Isn't it a pity the way things turned out for him?
It's awful. Duke, me and Jim, we ain't never been in the company of a real duke before. So you'll have to teach us how to act.
That's fine. Perhaps one of you could bring me something to eat? That'd be a nice touch. Come, friend. Come and join me.
I'm not hungry.
Would you care for some rabbit?
Oh, fine, James.
He called me James. Would you care for a piece of catfish?
Wonderful.
Here it comes. No. Just a minute there, boys. Now, you look here, Bilgewater. You're not the only person that has trouble like that.
No?
No, you ain't. You're not the only person that has a secret of his birth.
Wait, what do you mean?
Bathwater, I am the late Dofang.
You're who? What?
Yes, it's true. You see before you the poor disappeared Dofang, King Louis the 17th.
You?
Yes, it's true. I am the son of Louis the 16th and Mary Antoinette. You see before you in blue jeans and misery, gentlemen, the suffering, rightful King of France.
Catfish!
Thank you. Don't mind if I do.
Well, have you ever seen such royalty? The king and the duke, well, it looked as if the king and the duke were going to be on the raft for quite a while. So Huck and Jim decided they'd learn what they could from them. And as for the king and the duke, well, there was only one thing on their low-down minds, and that was money. Money, quick and easy.
Oh, thank you. Oh, now, don't look so angry now, Bilgewater. Come on now, we're going to be on this raft a long time together. What's the point of being angry? I always say make the best of things the way you find them. So, let's you and me shake hands and let's everybody be friends.
My brother, my comrade.
Well, isn't that sweet? I suggest we get to work on a plan to make some money.
I'm with you. What's our campaign?
Well, I was thinking, a good way to make some money is for me to do my preaching again, evangelism, as long as nobody has heard about my last preaching from up the river.
Too risky. Why not?
Why not what?
Let's trod the boards.
Gather round, brothers and sisters. Come, gather round. Hear the word of the Lord. Come, brothers and sisters. Come to the mourner's bench.
Amen.
Come, souls heavy with sin. Come, sick and sore. Come, let the Lord wash away your sin.
Hallelujah! Watch this. I'll show you how to make some real money. Preacher man, I'm yes. carrying a heavy load, and the Lord is burning a hole in my chest. I crave to speak.
Well, come on up and speak, brother.
Brothers and sisters, I am a bad man. I am an evil man. Brothers and sisters, I am a pirate.
No.
No, but do not fear.
Hang
me. No, don't hang me yet. Hear my words, brothers and sisters. Anyway, I have been a pirate out on the great Indian Ocean for 30 years. And most of my men were killed in a big fight last spring. So I came to town last night looking for recruits. Well, but I was robbed the minute I set foot off the boat. And they took every penny I had to my name. And so now I'm walking the streets without a penny in my pocket. But then I came across you good folks and this fine man here. And his words, oh Lord, his words sank into me like harpoons. And even though I don't have any money, I'm standing here a changed man, and I'm glad of it. Oh,
amen!
Amen is right, brother. The Lord has harpooned me deep in my heart, and I'm happy for the first time in my life.
Amen!
And I am going back to the Indian Ocean, even if I have to swim, by God. But I'm going to spend the rest of my days trying to pull those pirates away from evil and onto the true path of glory. And even though it's going to take me a long, long time without any money, I'm going to do it. And when those pirates try to thank me for saving their souls, I'll say, don't thank me. Thank the good people of Pokeville.
Let's take up a collection, boy. Use my hat, and if it ain't big enough, I'll get you another one.
Oh, I've been harpooned.
We hear you. Don't it surprise you the way these kings carry on?
No, they don't.
Why not?
Well, it just don't. I reckon it comes with their breed.
Well, these kings of ours are fakers. That's what they are. They're fakers.
Bless you. Bless you. Idiots and fools.
What's the take?
$87.
A good day's work.
Oh, no. Come here. We're just getting started. Bigger than a cow. My goodness, look at that monster. Oh, what a fish.
The devil.
Ow! Give me some rope.
There you go.
Now put the raft to the shore. Half of that money belongs to me!
Jim? Jim? Jack Nebbit! Jim! Damn their time!
I don't see the sense in taking them all the way back up the river. We can hang them right here.
I haven't killed anybody.
Fella, I have arrested you for the murder of one Huckleberry Finn, and you are going to hang for it. Well, let's go.
We didn't plan on being part of no necktie party.
Well, if you plan on collecting that reward, I expect you'll help me stretch his neck.
Well, let's get to it, then.
All right.
King, you know I didn't kill anybody. You know Huck's alive. Tell him.
Now, don't you try to hang yourself.
Quiet down. Come on.
Tell my children. Tell my children.
Tell them what? You was hung for a murderer? I'd be happy to.
Tell them their daddy died like a man.
All right.
A man.
I will. String him up, boys.
Go!
Stop! Stop! I'm Huckleberry Finn!
What did you say, son?
I said, I'm Huckleberry Finn!
That's a lie, Sheriff. That boy's name is George Miller. Now let's go.
You! You're the darn liar!
Look!
See, he knows me. They're lying, I'm telling you. God, I'll know you don't hate me.
Now, enough of this nonsense.
Jim, I tried. You hear me? I tried. Just close your eyes, Jim. Oh, God, they're gonna hate you. Oh, Lord. No! You men, stop that this instant. Widow Douglas.
Huckleberry?
Tell him, Widow. Tell him Jim ain't killed nobody.
You men back off from him. He's killed no one. And there's your proof. I don't know what shenanigans he's been pulling, but there is the boy that Jim is accused of killing, Huckleberry Finn. And when I get through with him, he's gonna wish he was dead. Now, you let him go right now.
I have got to hold him, ma'am. He is a runaway slave.
Him? You turn him loose this minute. He is no slave. He's as free as any man that walks this earth.
Ma'am, that doesn't make sense.
Oh, yes, it does. My sister, Des Watson, died 2 months ago, and she set Jim and his whole family free in her will. And I have the papers to prove it. It was her last wish. Read it.
Fella, you're free to go. Hold on there, you two. Where do you think you're going?
Oh, that way.
No.
That way.
No. This way.
Jim, can you hear me? Listen to me, Jim. You're free. You're a free man. So what are you gonna do now?
Meet my wife and children.
You remember which way to go?
Follow the river edge 2 miles. Tap the steamer going upriver, hug my wife and children, and that's my road to walk. What are you gonna do now, Huck?
I don't know. Run from my pap, I reckon. He'll be after me when he hears I'm still living.
You don't have to worry about that.
Sure I do.
No, you don't. You remember that house we found in the water? And there was a dead body inside. I wouldn't let you look at his face. Well, you can walk the earth the way you want to now. That man was your daddy.
That was my pap?
Yes, it was.
Well, that's good, ain't it? That means we're both free, don't it? Ain't that what that means, Jim?
That's what it means. I'm gonna miss you, Huck. I'll never forget you or what you've done for me.
Hush up that talk. You done just as much for me, and you know it. Go on now. You got a boat to catch.
Goodbye, Huckleberry Finn. I hope life is good to you.
You too, Jim. I don't know if I'll ever see Jim again, but I'll always remember all them adventures me and him had. Me and Jim was free men on that river. Well, that's the story of Huckleberry Finn.